Copilot is Microsoft's AI assistant that was first released on November 1st, 2023. There are actually two versions of Copilot. The first is called Copilot in Windows. This is a free AI assistant, much like ChatGPT. You may have already experienced it as Bing Chat in your Edge browser. Copilot in Windows is now rolling out to desktops, or it can be accessed on the web or in your Edge sidebar. Then there is Copilot for Microsoft 365, which is a paid license. This is what was released back in November, and it brings Copilot into your applications such as Word, Outlook, and PowerPoint. The easiest way to understand the difference, I found personally, is that Copilot in Windows is for asking general information or to produce generic content that's already publicly available. But Copilot in 365 is more about using company information, your existing documents and conversations, to generate content or answer your questions. I've been using Copilot in 365 for a few weeks now, and it's definitely still in its infancy stage. I think the most difficult thing, as with adopting any new technology, is understanding what it can do and remembering that it's there. It's very prominent when you open a new Word document. It'll just pop up and ask you what you want to write. And within apps like Word and PowerPoint and Excel, it's in the top ribbon to access. In New Outlook, it allows you to get email summaries or gives you help with writing emails. Within Teams, it can help you write chat messages, get meeting summaries, and you also get Copilot Chat, which lets you check in on colleagues, ask questions, generate ideas, and again, this will use internal company files and data to do so. Again, for me, it's remembering that Copilot is there. When I go to write a Teams message or an email, I just write it. I don't really think about using Copilot. However, the other day I did actually have some notes written up from a conversation with a colleague, and I asked Copilot to turn those notes into a case study. And it was actually quite useful. I didn't use the copy it gave me, but it helped me with like base content ideas and really brought forward key points from my notes. I don't think there's a definitive way to say it's good or it's bad, because it's all about how you use it and if your data is organized well enough to be used by it. But hopefully you at least know the difference between Copilot in Windows and Copilot in 365 now.